excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to. They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Lewis, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. The completion good for 3 and it's second down.
Because some of them, they need their teammates to scheme for them. So if you occupy people and make it a one-on-one matchup, other guys, they just do everything in front of them. To get 2 sacks in a game, that's a little bit of both for you.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets us into enemy territory across the 40. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on his first ride, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll be blocked out, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I said the staff is up in the booth watching the game. They may want to file that one away. See how fast the free safety kill is to make that play? Check it to a throw the next time.
Watch it now, Barney. Barney, here we go. Green.
On second down, Webb. His throw incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes where people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
The seventh play now, this opening drive. This is third and long now. Webb now. And incomplete. The contact made the ball run free and brings up fourth down. Take the field. And you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended? Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one, maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
Here we go!
To throw on second down. Webb. That will be taken down, but not before it gets into enemy territory. Sack number 6 for him on the year. third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
Here we go now. Boom, landed.
On the run, strong run, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. Gets a pickup before it to bring up second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
To throw on second down. Webb. And his throw is incomplete. Derek Hopper. That takes us from second to third down.
And missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off the drive. They had a chance there to finish things out. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys did not play offense.
Giants on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
All right, here we go. Boom, Landon!
Webb now from the gun. This is Shepard on the catch. And it's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I'm pretty sure the Giants saw big success for Sterling Shepard coming out of Oklahoma. They could see him in their offense working in the middle of the field and making big catches.
Second only to Michael Thomas last year among rookies in receptions, yards, and touchdowns. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
There's been a little time there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he's reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense, I think you're right. Looking to throw on second down. Webb. And he finds Shepard. Touchdown, Giants. Sterling Shepard. His second touchdown on the season. They're the Giants. Coming up in the Sunday night game, matchup you don't see very often, a rematch of Super Bowl 18. The Raiders traveling to Washington. And then tomorrow on Monday night, we'll see the Cowboys heading to the desert to take on the Cardinals.
Former NFC East Rivals.
A game of 3rd and 2.
They haven't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Across the 35. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving him a whole lot of fun and bucking him. Not much space to run him.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were good, except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by
Eagle pressure. Too much this time. Here he goes. Brandon Graham. He's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. What will Webb try to do here after the sack as he brings his guys up 3rd and 1?
All right, here we go.
Operating from the gun. And pressure gets to him again. Brandon Graham in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia. is the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
Deep inside their own territory.
He lost the football.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And he'll be out of bounds, getting it across the 25. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course,
a little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
The Giants on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. From the gun, Webb. It's caught, Shepard. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Now, this trio that New York has compiled, Brandon Marshall, Sterling Shepard, and, of course, Odell Beckham Jr., fits right into head coach Ben McAdoo's attack. They led the league in 3 wide receiver sets in 2016.
Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
And we can make this a pretty simple. That's a rookie mistake made by the rookie quarterback, trying to force a pass without really using proper mechanics.
Second down following the incompletion. Set to start the third quarter. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far, defense shut it down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's
pressure comes and down goes. The Eagles get there for the save. Vinnie Curry. Giants. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Vinnie Curry. In there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Offensively, they're going to have to figure this out before next week. 7 sacks in 1 game.
Yeah, and that's more than any quarterback should have to bear. And if this continues on, there will be another quarterback in the game because no one can stand up to this week after week.
Let's go!
To throw on second down. Webb. And fight for the football. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? No, you just throw that out the
window. I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they
attack him here.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Lamar's got his tight end Ingram. That he's brought down. They give him 13 yards here on the play and a fresh set of downs.
All right, here we go.
On first and 10, Webb. Caught right side. It's Lewis. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 10 yards on the pick up there.
That was a nicely run slant route. What the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And officially, it's no gain on the play, and they remain a few inches shy of the first with third down unit. The offense on third down today, they're at 50%, 4 for 8. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Led to throw. It's incomplete. They couldn't hook up. His time is now run out. He'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in those key downs. Because I've seen that, you know, you and I worked on
it. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of playing here. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with protocol. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time down, run the cut down, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Second down now after the incompletion. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and 3 now.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now through the defense, we're going to put a 2 on third down. You're a little off balance.
Possession, and that's become too familiar of a
routine. You know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base and he's on base, they bring his jacket up to him to keep him warm? A lot of times, the punter goes inside and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. To throw again. Shepard, and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. His height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback back to his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Going again. Webb. Jets first down. The Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor. It's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go into this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? Sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it.
Giants offense back out onto the field, and they've got to be still reeling from the events of a moment ago. Now. What a turn in that last play.
Knock it on the board. You're about to take it in. You think you're going to get some points on the board. Instead, you pop it up and watch them take it the rest of the way to the opposite end zone. That's a two-score swing that you just gave up. It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Throwing again on second and 10. Webb. And this will hold in. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pick up there, 26 yards. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And now escaping this time as he'll go down. They get him for a second. Fletcher Cox in there and drop him as the clock continues to roll. The linebacker, Michael Kendricks. So now he's equal his interception to